Dum 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 dum. Now that is kind of like the theme from Bonanza. I used to like that show back in the day. I'm old enough to remember Gunsmoke and stuff. But in the good old Dusters back in the day, the lawmen wearing their badge, the sheriff, the deputy, they would go after the villains, the vermin, and hunt them down, get a posse together. We're going to ride all over the place. As a matter of fact, Cindy and I traveled through New Mexico, where Billy the Kid used to ride. It was really cool going through, I think it's Lincoln, New Mexico, and all these areas. Doc Holliday, Billy the Kid, real, you know, villains and sheriffs and deputies. Well, one of the stories we've been told is the RCMP always gets its man, and I have no doubt they will eventually. That should be put to the end of it now. We will always get our man eventually. Because look at what happened in Canada recently, from Vancouver Island, two youths, and we are talking about youth, what is it, 19, 20 years old or something like that, went on a killing spree. They killed three people. Three people, an Australian woman, very tragic, an American young man, and a Canadian. So what happened now? Well, the RCMP has been hunting them from British Columbia through Alberta to Saskatchewan to Ontario. The federal government has thrown in the military to search for them. There's drones, there's heat sensors, there's all kinds of stuff, helicopters up there. They're doing everything to find these two outlaws, the two villains. They must be brought to justice, dead or alive, wanted dead or alive. Yeah, that's a ticket. But to no avail, these two have outfoxed the hounds that are after them. Oh my God, how can that be? Maybe they're lost in the woods and have been eaten by bears and wolves. Maybe mosquitoes have stung them to death. Who knows? But they've gotten away. Now, the thing that I think of this, it has to do with racism or something really screwed up, because two people kill three, which is tragic. That's not a joke. And the cost incurred to hunt them down is unbelievable. And you take a look at the Highway of Tears and First Nations, and there's a very good likelihood that there's a serial killer out there, or maybe multiple ones, multiple serial killers. And the government just doesn't seem to have put the same emphasis of mobilizing all the cops, the military, everything. Throw the book at finding who's been killing the First Nations people. Now, to me, that spells racism. Very simple. And you know, you have to wonder, is the life of one person worth more than the life of another person? It's, you know, it's very tragic. It's very tragic for the three people that have been murdered by these two youths. And it's very tragic that hundreds of First Nations women have either been murdered or have gone missing. And it's like getting blood out of stone to get the government and the cops and that to throw everything at it. Throw everything at a possible serial killer running in Canada, or multiple serial killers. At least that's the way I see it.